George Mariner Mall, back with the Discovery Orchestra's second installment of our chats on the Brahms Rhapsody, Opus 79, number 2, in G minor. Last time, we met the four motifs of the A section. Let's drill down into each of these a bit. Motif 1 has a two-step ascending sequence built into it. You'll remember that sequences are repetitions that change pitch level. Also notice that after it goes up, it comes down. And further notice that after Brahms presents this idea once, he actually moves the entire idea up in an ascending sequence. Listen to Christopher Johnson play this. Motif 2 goes to these two big chords, followed by very detached triplet subdivisions of the beat. Da-yum-da! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da You may remember that I said last week that motif 3 is chromatic and exotic. We've spoken about the chromatic scale before. It's the one where we skip nothing when we play it on the piano. All white keys and all black keys. Motif 3 begins with this chromatic idea. Now it happens twice, but the third time, the Brahms makes a tiny little change. It moves away from chromaticism. See if you can notice this. Now listen to Christopher play this. I also mentioned that motif 4 has an ostinato. You'll recall that an ostinato is a repeating melodic idea. Listen to it in context. Now, there's something else that happens toward the end of motif 4. It contains suspensions and resolutions. Suspensions and resolutions are incredible devices for creating tension and releasing that tension for listeners. To review how they're created, let's just listen to this. A composer begins on, let's say, this chord. Now, a chord, of course, has two pitches in it, at least. It can have more. It could have three or more, four, but at least two, consisting of a lower note and an upper note. Now, what happens is that the composer wants to go from one two-note chord to another one right below it. And what composers realized was that if they just change one of the pitches, if the top one moves down, but the lower one is suspended, it stays in place. It creates tension, which of course can be released by resolving the lower pitch to the next chord. Listen to these suspensions and resolutions in motif 4. Powerful stuff. Come back next time for the B section of this Rhapsody, and don't forget that the Discovery Orchestra will email you a PDF of the listening guide for this Rhapsody so that you can visually follow along, if you request one, at info@discoveryorchestra.org.